Goodbye 2020 and hello 2021. The problem is though, I seem to be going from disaster to disaster. What's happened? Stay tuned and find out. Boating, beautiful riverside scenery, and of course all of this seen through the eyes of a photographer. What more could you want?
With lockdown number 2, lock closures and flood alerts, I still hadn't moved Spirit from Earthlingborough in Northamptonshire. This section of the River Nene truly had been cut off.
Oh, 2020, what a year, eh? Oh, goodness me. I'm on my way to Spirit at the moment. If you remember, when we left off with Spirit last time, I was cruising from roughly Earls Barton area to Earthlingborough. Now, we are in the first week of January 2021 and the boat hasn't moved. Well, it has moved, but on its own accord. Just before Christmas, if things couldn't get any worse in 2020, the river's burst its banks. We had an almighty whole day of rain and it put the River Nene into flood. And what happened over Christmas was poor Spirit was set adrift. The mooring pins came out of the already soaking ground and drifted downriver and got stuck on a weir. So I've got my rope. I'm heading to Spirit now. We're going to see what she's like because I think she's taken a little bit of damage. But yeah, I've got to see where she is, where she got herself stuck, and try and figure out how to get her off the weir. So a bit of a exciting start to 2021. I hope you all had a good Christmas. Right, let's get on with the matter in hand. Wish me luck.
On cold and frosty winter mornings, the river can look so appealing. Within just a few hours and the help of the great British weather, all of that can soon change. It's absolutely incredible how the landscape changes after flooding. The fields were literally covered in freshwater shells.
Oh my gosh, I've just got my first look at the boat. Well, this is the part every boater dreads. I'm just coming up to the boat now. I can see her and this is the boater's worst nightmare, just seeing what sort of state the boat's in. How about that for a sunrise? Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Who would have thought that only a week before, all of this land was underwater?
It looks like the canopy's taken a bit of a hammering. Gosh. This is the moment every boater dreads, is coming up to the boat and just seeing what sort of damage has happened. So here she is. Ah. Oh. Yeah, it's definitely the canopy. Oh, poor Spirit. So this is the backwater. And what happened was that she got caught on the weir. So here's the backwater. I'm gonna have to talk quite loud now because the weir's quite noisy. There she is. Poor old Spirit. Thank goodness she's tied up nicely now, but I'm gonna have to sort that canopy out. She got stuck on here. So she drifted all the way down the backwater. When I first came to see her, this was a raging torrent. So I came out, when was it? The day after Boxing Day, to have a look. And all this water is up, there's absolutely nothing I could do. And poor Spirit, she was stuck, oh, just here. She was stuck here on the weir. So there's absolutely nothing I could do. The only thing I could think about doing was getting a grappling hook and just throwing the grappling hook over and dragging her across. But lucky I gave the Environment Agency a call, and Andy Hall from the Environment Agency is a top bloke. He came out as soon as he could, and he managed to tie up Spirit. So thank you so much, Andy. I really do appreciate your help. She's not looking too bad apart from the canopy. I'm going to have a look at the canopy now and see what I can do about it, because obviously I've got to make the decking watertight just in case we have any more rain. So I'll probably have to go and get a tarpaulin and throw a tarpaulin over. But I think lucky escape. Very lucky escape. I have to say though, it's a beautiful location. Really nice. So I think I'll take the drone up, show you the location, catch sunrise. Sunrise is nice today, it's beautiful. Yeah, so a bit of an adventure. This is what boating, well, this is not what boating should be about. Boating should be about being tied up and secure and safe. But yeah, we had unprecedented flooding. I'm waffling on now, so I'm just going to show you the beautiful scenery. Thank you.
I would say I have a fairly keen eye for detail, and I was taken back by the richness of colour in the skies at sunrise and the various species of trees, standing out from the traditional muted colours of wintertime. Even at this time of year, there is still a beauty in nature.
I have to say, I'm really, really sad. It's actually, Well, it's very frustrating. Oh dear, I wish I could have made a more upbeat video, but yeah, this is the nature of the beast. Unfortunately, yeah, we have had lots and lots of rain. We've had all these floods, and I guess, you know, unfortunately, Spirit has come out as a casualty of these floods. It does look like I'm going to have to try and replace the canopy and patch it up as best I can. So I've put the tarpaulin over her at the moment, but yeah, you know, when the weather gets better, then I can hopefully... Cool. The geese are noisy this morning. Anyway, when the weather is better, I can hopefully sort her out and tidy her up then. But thank you so much for your support. Happy New Year to you all, and thank you for supporting my channel. Every subscription is appreciated, so please, if you haven't already done so, hit that subscription button, and don't forget to like, give me a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for when I upload new videos. Anyway, I wish you all well, take care, stay safe, and see you all again soon. Bye-bye for now.
Even after all of that drama, I was able to take two images that I am personally proud of.